It's Matthew 24:13. But he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved.
Yeah, the scripture says the end of our faith is when we're in the closet of Yahweh Shai. So until we get to that point, we got to endure unto the end. And endure takes patience and suffering.
Okay. Well, you gotta go through things, man. The Lord's gonna take you through obstacles to build you up to be strong in that day, man. Or nothing will waver your faith, man. And not everybody has that, you know, like Char said.
Let me read this real quick. So this Titus chapter 2, verse 11. For the grace of the Most High that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men,
right,
teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. And that's our job in Scripture. That's all it boils down to. You know, you can't really get around it, you know. At the end of the day, you gotta believe what the words of Yahweh Shai, you know, comes with. It's faith. You know, you're not going to see everything he's going to talk about right now, but when you go through the trials and tribulations, you're going to see it. Then you know that, you know, what Yahweh Shai said was 100% truth.
And what side you fall on.
That's right.
And what side you fall on. Like when them traps start coming up and them hurdles start getting taller and taller, seems like, you be like, well, I'm getting tested right now.
Yeah.
Right? And that's, you get deep and deep, heavier and heavier in weights and higher strides just make you just that much limber to get over and leap over them things. You know? You gotta think of the world, not physically, right? You gotta think of it spiritually in your walk. Why did I goddamn go this way? What the hell am I doing in this store for real? Is it this shirt? Is it really this shirt that I'm goddamn here in the store for? Or is it something that I'm supposed to see? You know? And you gotta measure these things, man. That's what a true carpenter measures everything. Remember that sideboard with the sideboard, his eye just calculating every goddamn thing. Everything is being calculated in his vision. And this is how we're supposed to walk. Calculating everything in our vision. Everything. No matter how small it is, man. Well, how the hell am I here?
Well, you know what? You know, I think you're going to get too technical with the scriptures. Because it tells you that, you know, a man's going to the Lord.
Yeah, yeah.
So everything, you know, that happens on you is not about, you know, why me? Just, you know, praise the Lord, the Abba, Shema, Shai, Tawara, you know, for giving me the courage to go through this trial. Because at the end of the day, you know, your faith has to be built up.
Yeah,
because it's not about you alone. It's about those that are going to count you, you know, to the gospel, you know?
This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 6 and verse 17.
Go ahead.
It says, for the very true beginning of her is the desire of discipline.
Because when you go through those trials and tribulations, what do you learn? You learn the wisdom. And at the very beginning, what? The desire of discipline. Which what? Fear will teach you what? Discipline. All right, go ahead.
It says, and the care of discipline is love.
And the care of discipline is love. You see? Because what? Ultimately, you get that discipline, get that care to what? To help build the body at the end of the day. Because it's not about yourself, you know? But that was it. That was it. Unless you,
it's a little bit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It says, and love is the keeping of the key, Salakia, and love is the keeping of her laws. And the giving heed unto her laws is the assurance of incorruption.
Yeah, we have the full assurance of incorruption. Of incorruption through Yahweh Shai, the whole word. You know, it's entirety. All right, the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is entirety, right? So you can read the scriptures and see and say, yeah, the commandments, yeah, we can look at the commandments, the most of the commandments, but it's an entirety. It's about faith. All right, it's about faith and doing what? Actually disciplining and constructing your life to where you're actually situated in your foundation in Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, that alone. Now, that goes into that discipline, man. All right, because if you don't have discipline, then you're without fear. All right, and even without fear, then you're a fool. All right, and that's one of them. Remember, the scriptures tell you that the controversy that the Most High has with the inhabitants thereof is what? That no one feared the Lord. All right, why? Because if you don't fear the Lord, then you ain't going to lay the Lord down. And if you ain't going to lay the Lord down on nobody else, you ain't going to lay the Lord down on yourself, first and foremost. And that's what it boils down to, man. So if you care about the word, you care about the body, you want to discipline yourself, first and foremost. All right?
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse... I'll read 27. I'll start up. Verse 24. Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize, so run that ye may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things.
Yeah, well balanced, you know.
And the brother, you have to keep going into, man. You gotta keep in mind that man's goings are of the Lord. So you can't get too down on yourself. You know, you can't kick yourself in the ass. You know, you can't be, oh, damn, why'd I do this? Why'd I do this? Sometimes the Most High put things in your mind and make you do certain things that you necessarily wouldn't want to do. But he make you do it, so what? You have to go through that learning experience. Because only through experience, that's how you learn that discipline. That's how you learn to fear the Lord. All right? You ain't going, the only way you learn to fear, the, when you go back to, what's that? Joshua, right? When you go to the book of Joshua, the first couple chapters, you got Rahab, which she was counted as a person of faith, right? But what? She knew about the fear of Yahweh because of the tribulation that the children of Israel went through. That was the whole sole purpose, all right? To put fear in the minds of the people, to put fear in the minds of the children of Israel. But then you see throughout the time they went through the wilderness, they didn't keep that fear, all right? They chose to fear men rather than Yahweh Bashem Yahshai. And after the Most High, he killed Moses too. He killed Moses, all right? He killed Aaron, he killed all of them. And all the spies that went into the land, they all died except two, all right? Joshua and Caleb, all right? Why? Because they kept the fear of the Lord, all right?
1 Corinthians 9:25, and every man that strives for the master is temperate in all things.
Right.
Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run not as uncertainly, so fight I, not as the one that beateth the air.
Yes, let me say this, because it's easy to get the glory of this world. It's all good. Yeah, it's easy to get the glory of this world, man. It's easy to do stupid things. It's easy to look good in this world. Alright? You got whores that look good in this world. You got the wicked is looking good in this world. Alright? So it's easy to look good in this world. Fuck this world. Alright? Those are dope. And now the scriptures are talking about those that seek a corruptible crown. By what? Doing things based upon the fashion of this world and getting the glory of men. Alright, but when the glory of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai comes, it's not in the fashion of the world. The world's gonna hate you. The world is gonna view you as a scumbag. The world be real, man. Alright?
Verse 27. And bring it into subjection.
Right, so it says, I keep under my body. What does the word keep mean? It means to watch. I watch over my body. And what?
And bring it into subjection.
Meaning what? The spirit has been exercised to where it's more powerful than the desires of the flesh. You see? And only by experience and discipline, that's the only way you have your senses exercised in your body. As the scripture tell you, man. All right, that's how you grow up, having your senses and your spirit exercised. Through those experiences.
Go ahead. It says, lest that by any means, when I preach to others, I myself should be a castaway.
Right, see, he said, lest by any means I should preach to others, I myself be a castaway. Because it's easy to have those pleasant words and make a good speech and be a great orator. You know, especially in a society where our people don't know much. You know? It's easy to tell a nigga, yo, this is science, dog. You know, and they break down some shit, how far the star is from the moon, and the moon, and the lights, and the firmaments, and how fast light travels. He's like, whoa, that's deep. You know? So it's easy to do that, man. But when you break down, the biggest thing about what we have to offer, right, is the main thing is that we're not glorifying of ourselves, we're glorifying Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Matter of fact, and if I'm not mistaken, that's in the same chapter. He said, what, my glorying is in the glory of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. No glory in yourself, you know? Why? Because the way you got to know the true power of the Lord is by you getting your ass kicked.
That's right.
That's the way you know the Lord. We know the Lord through our downs and outs, all right? That's why the scriptures tell you what? To glory in your afflictions.
Yeah, right.
All right? Why? Because what? In affliction, the righteous seek the Heavenly Father early, man. But it's going to be too late for others because what? They walk by, although they're in their affliction, they got that pride in their mind, and they didn't have that care, discipline, they didn't have that love. All right? So when that affliction hits them, they're going to be looking to seek the Lord early, but it's going to be too late.
in all reality, when the scriptures tell you that they're going to seek the Lord, right? It's basically too late, right? Just put it like that. I don't want to take too much. Go ahead.
It's the wisdom of Solomon 1:5. It says, It's the wisdom of Solomon 1:3. It says, for froward thoughts separate from the Most High.
Yeah, froward thoughts. Meaning, what the word froward mean? It means to be crooked. All right? Crooked thoughts separate from the Most High. Go ahead.
And his power, when it is tried, reproveth the unwise.
Right, and that's why, let me say this too, we're going to go back. That's why you have to keep your medicine strong. That's why you have to keep your prayers up, man. You have to constantly continue in prayer. Why? For the Most High to guide your mind, man. All right, to guide your steps. All right, although we know that the Most High don't guide our steps, we're not supposed to just be like, oh, you know what, fuck it, the Most High put me here, oh well, I'm going to just deal with it. Nah, it don't work that way. Although you are going to deal with it, all right, but the Most High wants you to ask for guidance. He wants the ultimate counselor in the scriptures. All right, but our brother's talking about the counselor, but that's true. But proper counsel comes from what? The scriptures. All right, you have to govern your temple. You have to make sure your temple is clean. You know?
Go ahead. It's wisdom of Solomon 1:3. For froward thoughts separate from the Most High. And his power, when it is tried, reproveth the unwise.
Yeah, when it's tried, it proveth the unwise, man. All right, go ahead.
Verse 4, for unto a malicious soul, wisdom shall not enter.
Yeah, a malicious soul, wisdom is not going to enter. Why? Because through the tribulation, they forgot Yahweh Bashem Yahusha. All right, they pushed Yahweh Bashem Yahusha to the side. That's why we push the affliction, if you will. We push, all right, the persecution, Jacob's trouble. All right? We acknowledge those factors. So what? You become concentrated in these times to where you don't have to, you already in the game. You know? By the fourth quarter, it's 2 minutes left. You don't put somebody in the game that ain't in rhythm. All right? You're supposed to be already in rhythm. You're supposed to be within, supposed to be in the game within the game already. Know what's going on, what to expect. Why? So when that crunch time hits, all right, you know how to play your role. Okay? But a lot of people ain't gonna know how to play their role because they scared to get into the game, man. All right? Shit is moving fast. All right? You ain't take your time out on your warm-ups and, you know, you ain't do the necessary things to prepare you for the game. All right? Go ahead.
For it's a malicious soul, wisdom shall not enter.
Right? Go ahead.
Nor dwell in the body that is subject unto sin.
Yeah, the body that is subject unto sin. All right? Why? Because the spirit ain't working with you, man. If your body is subject to sin, all right? If you find yourself in the same situation over and over again, over and over again, all right, why? Then what does that mean? The scriptures tell you what? It says a just man falleth 7 times and getteth back up, right? But the wicked falleth into mischief. So if you fall into mischief, that means you're not the just man that got back up, all right? You're a malicious soul, man, because you hate reproof. Go ahead.
It says, for the Holy Spirit of discipline will flee deceit.
The Holy Spirit of discipline, meaning what? Only by the Holy Spirit will you learn discipline in the first place. You find yourself in a quarrel, you're supposed to call upon Yahweh Bashem Yahushua for the Holy Spirit to come and sup with you so you can get out of that quarrel. Okay? And if you don't do that, in your mind, you're just going to find your own little passage, if you will. You're going to find your own destruction. Yeah, you basically, you're going to find your own destruction, but you're going to find your own device. That's why the scriptures tell you about the wicked intentions of a man. I believe that's the same chapter.
Hey, Psalms 10.
Right? Go ahead.
It says, for the Holy Spirit of discipline will flee deceit and remove from thoughts that are without understanding.
That's the point right there, because when you pray to Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, essentially what are you asking for? You're asking for the Holy Spirit to guide you. All right? Not my will, but what? Yours be done. All right, so when you pray that prayer, you're asking for the Yahweh Bashem Yahusha to put the Spirit on you for you to do the right thing. All right? And in the scripture tell you what? Whatever you ask in my name, then the Most High Yahweh Bashem Yahusha is going to deliver unto you, man. Okay? Go ahead.
It says, and remove from thoughts that without understanding,
right,
and will not abide when unrighteousness cometh in.
You see? And will not abide when unrighteousness cometh in. Because what? Unrighteous thoughts are going to come into your mind, but that, because that spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahusha is so strong, and you prayed your prayer,
right,
and the Most High has seen you faithful,
right,
he's going to flee those wicked thoughts.
Right.
You're not going to be succumbed to those thoughts, man, because our bodies are vessels that are being guided by spirits one way, shape, or another. Now, whether it's the Holy Spirit or wicked spirits, that's between you and the Heavenly Father. That's why you have to build that relationship with Yahweh Bash and Yahweh Shai. So he does guide you the right way to these last days unto salvation. All right?
Verse 6, it says, for wisdom is a loving spirit and will not acquit a blasphemer of his words. The Most High is a witness of his reigns and a true beholder of his heart and hearer of his tongue.
Yeah, see? That's right, man, because the scriptures tell you that the prayer of a wicked man is an abomination unto the Lord, man. But the scriptures tell you what? That the Most High hears the prayers of the righteous. All right? So if you have good intentions toward the body, guess what? Yahweh Bashem Yahshua is going to fulfill that. He's going to fulfill your prayer. Why? Because he knows that your intentions are to glorify him. You see? Why you think Paul was brought back to life, or Paul was able to overcome the different obstacles that he had to go through? Because the Most High knew that his mind and his spirit was subjugated or set out to satisfy the Heavenly Father and his Son. All right? If you have evil intentions, all right, the Most High not going to give you, or the Most High will give you certain things and then let you just basically walk yourself off a cliff. All right? You know?
Yeah, buddy, brother, want to jump in?
Sure. You know, also, as well, you know, this truth is spiritual money, right? Now, they got a saying in the world that when you gain money, right? Money doesn't make you, you know, become an asshole. Money makes you whatever you already was, right? Money just exposes that. Right? It amplifies it. It exposes who you really are. It's the same thing with this truth spiritual. You know, this truth, as soon as it enters your vessel, right, it's going to expose first and foremost. You're going to be the first one to be exposed to who, you know, to who you are and the changes that you need to make. That's why the Lord said, what? Because, you know, to what? Examine yourself. All right? Examine yourself. When the scripture says to be circumspect, it's not only talking about, you know, as far as prophecy, but remember, circumspect means what? You gotta look around. It starts with you. It starts with you. Why? Because you don't want to be a hypocrite. The Lord hates hypocrites, man. Alright?
This is Hebrews 4:12. For the word of the Most High is quick and powerful,
right,
and sharper than any two-edged sword, mm-hmm, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit.
Right. The words of the Lord is again, when the scripture says that to not give credit to a man. Right? And not have don't have a man be, you know, don't be quick to make a man your friend. Why? Because the scripture says the trial of all men is in their words. Alright, so when a man is speaking according to the words of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, you know what he's about. Okay? You know what he's about. And then when you know that, then guess what? Now you're okay, that's my brother, that's my friend. But if a man is not speaking according to these words, what does the scripture say in Isaiah? The light is not in him.
Right.
And what is the light? It's one thing to say the light is the, but what is the light? It's Yahweh Shah. And what is the spirit of Yahweh Shah? It's the spirit of prophecy. The difference between Great Millstone and the rest of these other camps is what? As prophets, guess what we do? We prophesy. You know? And there's another saying as well. I think that was Aristotle of ancient Greece. He made a saying that pretty much hit me. He said that you are what you repeatedly do. So therefore, it's not a singular act, it's a habit. Alright? This is not a singular act, this is a habit. This is who we are. So we're not trying to be Hebrew Israelites, we are Hebrew Israelites. We are the prophets of the Lord. Because repeatedly, we out here in the highways and the edges. We putting out our videos, right? We making sure the body is okay. That's what we do for a living.
Right.
So we are, if not us, then who are the real prophets?
Right.
You know? And we build confidence upon that, right?
Who else is doing what we do?
Not getting you guys.
Nah, go ahead.
Nah, who else is doing what we do?
That's right.
You know, and who's consistent?
Right. And who else is doing what we do in the fashion in which we doing it?
The right way.
Right. In the fashion in which we doing it, in the doctrine.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Because, hey, it's easy. Somebody would say, well, what about that other kid? Well, what about that other kid? Well, yeah, they're pushing the doctrine, but the Lord said, beware of the scribes and the Pharisees' bread. That's what he said. Beware of the scribes and the Pharisees' bread, which he meant their doctrine.
Yeah. All
right?
What they got to offer.
Yeah. Hebrews 4:12. For the word of the Most High is quick and powerful,
right,
sharper than any two-edged sword, mm-hmm, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit.
Right. The reason why the words of the Lord is a two-edged sword, because it's meant to cut you as you're cutting your brother. That's the reason why. Because the thing is that, again, you can't hold this sword as a hypocrite. You can't do it. You can't do it. How are you going to be an adulterer and you're going to stand to your brother and say, man, stop committing adultery? You got to cut yourself. So the Lord has got a sword that's going to cut you. And then when you allow, and this is faith, you got to allow this sword to cut you. Before you can actually start swinging the sword and cutting somebody else. And how do those cuts happen? Remember, what is a cut? A cut, it's a divide. What's a divide? A divide is what? It's judgment. Alright? Right for Hebrews 12. 12 and 2 from 8. Lord chastise.
This is Hebrews chapter 12. Right? And verse 8. Right? It says, but if ye be without chastisement, right? Whereof all are partakers, right? All the elected partakers of the chastisement. And 2,000 are not being chastised. Now they say, well, what about, you know, slavery? No, but see, the hell that you catch it from being a slave, that's just the average hell that all Israelites gotta deal with. But there's a whole different level when you come, when you deal with the truth and catching hell while in the truth. Okay? Something totally different. Right?
Verse 8 says, but if ye be without chastisement, whereof all are partakers, then are ye bastards and not sons.
That's right. Now, keep going. I want the part where it says he deals with you. Six.
Read up. Verse 6, it says, for whom the Lord loveth, he chastiseth,
right?
And scourge every son whom he receiveth.
And scourge every son whom he receiveth.
Right? Verse 7, if ye endure chastisement,
right?
The Most High dealeth with you.
That's right. So if you endure the chastisement of the Lord, the rebuke of the Lord, right? Regardless of how it's coming, it ain't always, listen, rebuke, it ain't always nice. A lot of times, rebukes ain't nice. It ain't supposed to be nice. Alright? It ain't supposed to be nice. But guess what? You gotta take, right? That's what balance is all about. Balance is about what? You got the nice and you got this. The not so nice, the ugly. You gotta be able to take both. All right. Now the scripture says that what? If you receive chastisement, the Lord dealeth with you. Now when you look at that word dealing, right? The word deal means what? Guess what comes up? Divide. Because remember, you know when you deal cards, a card dealer, right? What do? You dividing cards, you splitting cards. Well, the divide, it goes back to what? Hebrews 12. It tells you that the word of the Lord what? Divides. That's what it is. And the dividing is a judgment, it's a cut. The only way you're going to divide is by cutting. So how's the Lord doing? The Lord is cutting you with his words, and then he put through trials and tribulations so he will open up your eyes to yourself.
Yeah, separate you from the world.
That's right. Separate you from the world, and it's crazy because when you look up the word rebuke, another word that comes up is exposed. Okay? So you got to be exposed.
That's what the light does.
Right.
Supposed to be darkness. Yeah. Which is, you know, with at one point in time, what even still today, that we still going through the act of purging out, you know, that level. You know?
Yeah.
The Passover coming around, you know, it's a spiritual month, you know, spiritual time.
Yeah, it's not physical, it's spiritual,
right? Yeah, that's right. That's right. Yeah, yeah. Because, you know, right about the Passover time, you still got a lot of guys out here
focusing on looking at, you know, the back of the
box, and, you know, like, man, I gotta be trained or whatever, man, you know. Like, you missing a point, man. You missing a point. Because guess what? If a man ate 11 during that period of time, right? You know, a piece of 11 bread. If a man actually ate physical level, but was able to remove spiritual level, who is better? The man who keeps the spiritual level, that bullshit that he got in him, but make sure that he stays away from the physical level, or the man that's able to what? To be self-respect, examine himself through the spirit of power, Yahweh Shemal Shah, that level be removed from within him, but yet he consumed physical level. Which one is better? It's clearly the spiritual man. And that's what the Lord is trying to tell us. The Lord tells you, can I get that right quick? 1 Corinthians 15 and 46.
1 Corinthians chapter 15. is 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Verse 46.
Right.
It says, how be it that was not first which is
Peter slow.
Right. Hebrews, 1 Corinthians 15 and 46.
Right.
How be it that was not first which is spiritual.
See that? How be it that was not first which was spiritual. Right.
But that which is natural.
But that which is natural. Meaning, what the Lord gave us first was the carnal understanding. It's the carnal, like example, the leaven. When you're looking at the leaven, you're looking at the natural leaven. But the Lord said, that's what I said first, the natural leaven. But what I really want you to get is the second part, which is the spiritual leaven. Alright? That's why even when you go to Genesis, who was sent? The first Adam. It tells you the first Adam was what? He was the natural Adam. The second Adam being the house shall be spiritual. So that's how the Lord always moves. That's why you got to see past. The Heavenly Father's solutions is rarely on the first move. It's the move after the first move. Look at the Old Testament, the New Testament, right? The Old Testament is all one book, but the Old Testament, that's the Most High first move. But the ultimate understanding comes with in the Most High second move, which is the New Testament. Because that's when Yahweh Shah comes in.
Right? By the ultimate thinking game of chess.
That's right.
You know?
Everything is a setup. Even when you spar and stuff, like the jab is a setup. Yeah. Right? When you even go into combat, it's all about setting up something. But see, Jake always falls for the setup.
Yeah, he falls for the jab.
They fall
right
into
it.
1 Corinthians 15 and 46.
Right?
How be it? That was not first which is spiritual,
right?
But that which is natural,
right?
And afterward, that which is spiritual.
And afterward, that which is spiritual. That's why you always what? You have to remain spiritual. Why? Because the first thing that hits you is the carnal understanding. And then you get past the carnal, it's the spiritual understanding. Okay?
48, 45?
Yeah,
45. 45, it says, and so it is written. The first man, Adam, was made a living soul, and the last Adam was made a quickening spirit.
That's right, because the first Adam came in, of course, in the form of, the man, he had the body and everything like that. But the first Adam didn't have the quickening spirit, meaning what? The spirit to revive spirit, to revive other spirits. Because remember when Yahushua passed, when Yahushua died, and he was resurrected, that whole process was spiritual. His reservation was spiritual. Why? Because with his wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, we were going to be resurrected. We were going to be quickened. Adam couldn't have it. As a matter of fact, Jake, a lot of times when you first come in, who do you blame for the situation and, sinning and all that?
Esau.
Well, of course, but when you come up in the church, they got you blaming. Now, Adam, going back to the garden. Going back to the garden. Because remember, of course the scripture tells you it's through Eve we all die, but Adam was Eve's covering. So it all happened under Adam. And when that happened, what happened? Were we quickened through Adam? No. We started to taste death through Adam. So he was nothing but just a living soul. But the second Adam, that same spirit coming back as Yahusha, he quickened us. He made us alive. Okay? That's what we need to be quickened.
They kept the law light. If I can add on to that point too, if you read it, Romans the 5th chapter, that's why it says, through one man's sin, we all die. But then that same, it said, through one man, we all
get it.
Yeah,
that's right. Oh, yeah, you got that
Sirach
16:3?
Yeah, 16. This is the book of Sirach.
Hold it.
Yeah, that's right. It's about the bigger picture, man. It's about the manifold wisdom of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. We always talk about twofold. The scriptures tell you that the wisdom of the Heavenly Father is manifold. It's layers on top of layers. That's why, hey, a lot of times, look, you got to get out of the, you got to find your walk. I'll say that. You got to find your walk with Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. And everybody's walk is different. Everyone walk is different, man. And you come up, what does scripture say? You come up as under tutor, but until a time appointed. Because after a while, you learn from what your tutor did, but after you have to make your own discernment to make your own decisions based upon what the Spirit is telling you now.
That's right.
You know?
That's right.
You got it?
Yeah. This is Romans chapter 5, verse 17. It says, for if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in the life by one, Yahushua HaMashiach.
Yeah, that's right. So, you know, it's the same Spirit. You know, that's why it's important to know, right, about reincarnation. You know, if you don't know about reincarnation, then you can't make the link. But guess what? The only way for you to know about reincarnation, the Holy Spirit has got to be with you. All right? Right quick, I want you to sign in Bible 17. You know, it's funny because, you know, guys always say, well, the Holy Spirit. Do you even know what the Holy Spirit it does? You know, what is you know, the reason for the Holy Spirit? What does it do? You know what I'm saying? What does it do? The Holy Spirit puts everything together.
Yeah, it sucks with you. It feeds you.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's your guidance.
That's right.
You know? Going back to faith. When you're talking about Abraham, he was out there with no landmarks. Right. Guess who was with him? The Holy Spirit.
Wow.
You know?
That's right.
The Holy Spirit is what guides you, man.
Right.
You know, the Holy Spirit is what teaches men.
That's
you know,
right.
And the Holy Spirit is what shows you the understanding based upon what you've been taught out of the scriptures.
Right.
That's why it's all tied to the so-called, you know, it's not really the Trinity, but it is one.
Yeah.
All right, scripture tell you that in John, man. All right, it is one. You got blood, water, and there was one more. They're all witness of the Heavenly Father, man. All right?
Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 9, verse 17. And thy counsel, who hast known, except thou give wisdom and send thy Holy Spirit from above.
There you go. So the Lord is going to give you wisdom and send his Holy Spirit from above. So it's through the Holy Spirit that you get the wisdom, the true wisdom, right? And then you wonder why certain guys have been in the truth for years and they just can't get certain things. Why? Because guess what? They got spirits, but they don't have the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, let me bring this out. Yeah, come. This is 1 John chapter 5, and I'm going to start verse 7. For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Spirit. And these three are one. And there are three that bear witness in earth, the Spirit, and the water, and the blood. And these three agree in one. And we receive the witness of men, meaning these teachings, right? The witness of the Most High is greater, which that's the Holy Spirit. For this is the witness of the Most High, which he had testified of his son. You see, and because we're able to come out here and teach this word, we come together under one banner, that's the witness of Yahusha. That's the Spirit bearing witness in one. All right, that proves right there that the Holy Spirit is with us, because we can come here and agree on the word of the Lord, which is the representation of Yahusha. So that's why it's all tied into one. That's where they get the whole Trinity thing and it's all mixed up. But you got to understand, like the brother was going into, it's about what the Holy Spirit is doing. All right? The Holy Spirit is gathering everything under one banner, man. You can't have one fraction over here saying that, oh, we got the truth. And all these people, they got the truth. Right? But that, the Holy